My name's William Stanton. I'm an orthopedic surgeon practicing in Fort Pierce, Florida. The particular procedure I do is something called an anterolateral approach. It is muscle sparing, much in the same way as an anterior approach is. So we're not cutting any muscle, we're going in between the muscles. In this approach, we're gonna go between the muscles to get to the femoral neck. The first job is to make a cut in the femoral neck. That allows us to remove the ball. The ball and socket are both bad when you're gonna do a total hip replacement. So the first thing we do is make the femoral neck cut, take the ball out, and then all through this small incision, gain access to the socket, also known as the acetabulum. The acetabulum is then shaped using a reamer, and then a metal cup is placed into the acetabulum. That metal cup is gonna be the back. So then the liner, which is a plastic liner, gets locked into that backing, the acetabular cup. The next step is then to address the thigh bone side or the femoral side. Femoral head's already gone, then you prepare the femur itself. The femur itself has to be prepared in order to accept a femoral component. The femoral components now are relatively small and narrow that can fit easily into inside the top portion of the upper femur. And then a ball needs to be attached onto that femoral component. Then that ball is reinserted back into the socket. And that's a hip replacement.